हेलो व्यूअर्स, आई एम डॉक्टर नीलू धीर फ्रॉम आचार्य नरेंद्र देव कॉलेज. आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद आवर सीरीज ऑफ केमिकल काइनेटिक्स. इन माय लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द इंटीग्रेटेड रेट लॉ फॉर ए जीरो ऑर्डर रिएक्शन. एक्स इज इक्वल टू के टी एंड द यूनिट्स ऑफ के आर मोल्स पर लीटर पर सेकेंड. द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ जीरो ऑर्डर रिएक्शन आर the plot of the concentration x versus time is a straight line with slope equal to k. The equation of the integrated equation of the zero order reaction a naught minus a t is equal to nu 1 k t can be used to determine the time required for the reaction to be complete, that is when AT becomes equal to 0. If we put AT is equal to 0 and rearrange for T completion, we get T completion is equal to A naught by nu 1 K. Examples of zero order reaction are enzyme catalyzed reactions, substrate giving products catalyzed by enzyme, decomposition of HI on gold surface. First order reaction. If we have a reaction A gives products and it is first order with respect to A, let small a be the concentration of the reactant A at time t is equal to 0 and A minus x be the concentration at time t is equal to t, where x is the amount of products formed at time t is equal to t. We can write the rate of a reaction as minus dA by dt is equal to dx by dt is equal to rate constant k into the concentration of A, which can also be written as k into concentration of A minus x. dx by dt is equal to k into A minus x. Separating the variables, dx by A minus x is equal to k dt. On integrating, we get minus ln A minus x is equal to kt plus c. At t is equal to 0, x is equal to 0, c is equal to minus ln A. Substituting this value of c in the above equation, minus ln A minus x is equal to kt minus ln A. On rearranging, we get ln A over A minus x is equal to kt. If we convert the natural log into the log to the base 10, we have to multiply it by the factor of 2.303. So, kt becomes equal to 2.303 log A over A minus x. Alternatively, we can also find out the first order rate equation by using the reaction nu 1 A plus nu 2 b gives products, and the rate expression depends only on the concentration of one of the species, say A. So order with respect to A is 1 and order with respect to B is 0. So we can write down the rate as minus 1 by nu 1 dA by dt is equal to k1 into concentration of A. dA by A becomes equal to minus nu 1 k1 dt. Integrating within the limits a0 to at and from time t is equal to 0 to t, we get ln at by a0 is equal to minus nu 1 kt. और ln a naught by at is equal to nu 1 kt. We can replace at by a naught minus nu 1 x, so that we get ln a naught by a naught minus nu 1 x is equal to nu 1 kt. For most of the first order reactions, nu 1 is equal to 1. Thus, ln a naught by a naught minus x is equal to k1 t. It can also be written as a t is equal to a naught exponential minus k t and is known as Wilhelmy's equation. The concentration of A decreases exponentially with time, as can be shown in the graph also. Characteristics of first order equations. The first order integrated rate equation is written as ln a naught minus ln a t is equal to k1 t, or ln a t is equal to ln a naught minus k1 t, and we can convert it into the base to log to the base 10 by dividing the k1 term by 2.303. So if we plot a graph between log a t and t, we would get a straight line with slope equal to minus k by 2.303. Also, if we plot log a naught by a t versus time, we will get a straight line with slope equal to k by 2.303, and the line will pass through origin. So there are two characteristic graphs of a first order equation. One is log a naught by a t versus time, and the other is log a t versus t, whose slope is equal to k by 2.303. Half life t, half of a reaction, is the time required for the concentration of reactants to decrease by half. That is, a t is equal to a naught by 2. Substituting this in the first order rate equation, ln a naught by a t is equal to k1 t, we get ln a naught by a naught by 2 is equal to k1 t half, or 2.303 log 2 is equal to k1 t half. And t half becomes equal to 2.303 log 2 by k1, which is equal to 0.693 by k. So we see that t half is independent of the initial concentration of the reactant. Examples of first order reactions are decomposition of di-tertiary butyl peroxide, decomposition of di-nitrogen pentoxide, decomposition of thionyl chloride, decomposition of 2,4,6-trinitrobenzoic acid, decomposition of hydrogen peroxide. These are all the examples of first order equations. We can also have a general integrated rate equation for an nth order reaction. It is possible to derive the general expression of integrated rate law for a reaction whose rate depends either on the concentration of only one reactant or on different reactants having same stoichiometric coefficients and identical concentrations. If all stoichiometric coefficients are assumed to be unity, we may write the general differential law as dx by dt is equal to kn into a naught minus x to the power n, where n is the order of the reaction. So, we are deriving the integrated rate equation for an nth order reaction. We can separate the variables and integrate to get the equation 1 by n minus 1, 1 by a naught minus x to the power n minus 1, minus 1 by a naught to the power n minus 1 is equal to kn into t. The above equation is not applicable for n is equal to 1. The units of the rate constant kn are written as mole to the power 1 minus n, liter to the power n minus 1, second inverse. The half-life of the reaction can be determined by replacing a naught minus x in the above equation by a naught by 2. So, by doing this replacement, we get the equation 1 by n minus 1, 2 to the power n minus 1 minus 1 divided by a naught to the power n minus 1 is equal to kn t half. So, t half becomes equal to 1 by kn n minus 1, 2 to the power n minus 1 minus 1 by a naught to the power n minus 1. Determining the order of a reaction. The order of a reaction is always determined experimentally on the basis of the dependence of the rate of reaction on the concentrations of the reacting species. To determine this dependence, we have to find out how the concentration of reacting species or products vary during the course of reaction. In many reactions, the concentration of the substance can be determined without disturbing the reaction mixture. This is accomplished by measuring a suitable property of the mixture. It changes due to the change in the concentration of a reactant or product. Few examples are the reactions such as inversion of cane sugar can be followed polarimetrically. If in a reaction ions are consumed or produced, or one ion is replaced by another, the concentration of the reacting species at different time intervals may be determined conductometrically. If in a reaction there occurs a change in the amount of gaseous species, then the concentration of various species at various time intervals may be determined from the change in the pressure of a constant volume reaction vessel or the change in volume of a constant pressure reaction vessel. The other analytical techniques such as potentiometry, polarography and spectrophotometry may be employed to determine the concentration of a reactant or a product at different time intervals. Once the concentration of the reacting species during the course of the reaction at different time intervals is determined, the order of the reaction and its rate constant may be determined by the following methods. first is the integration method. In this method, the data is substituted into the integrated rate equations for the different order reactions. The equation which gives almost a constant value of K decides the order of a reaction. We can start fitting the data in the various orders of the as given in the table below, and whichever equation is going to give us a constant value of K is going to decide the order of the reaction. We have the characteristic rate equation of a zero order reaction or a first order reaction. We can substitute the data obtained into the rate equation by a hit and trial method, and whichever equation is going to give us a constant value of K is going to determine the order of the reaction. Graphical method. In this method, the data are plotted according to the different integrated rate equations so as to yield a straight line. Rate constant of the reaction is calculated from the slope of the resultant straight line plot. So, we plot the data into the different integrated rate equations. Whichever graph gives us the straight line gives us the order of the reaction. Like for the zero order reaction, as can be seen from the table, if we plot AT versus time and if we get a straight line, then it is a zero order reaction. But if we don't get a straight line, then we need to plot the second. For the first order rate equation, the characteristic graphs, as we have already discussed, ln AT versus time. If this gives us a straight line, then it is a first order reaction, and so on. So, we have discussed the integration method and the graphical method to determine the rate of a to order of a reaction. On the basis of these two methods, we have an experiment to study the hydrolysis of methyl acetate at room temperature in the presence of hydrochloric acid. The experiment deals with the hydrolysis of methyl acetate in acidic medium. The reaction that takes place is ester plus water catalyzed by H plus ions gives CH3COOH plus CH3OH. The rate law may be written as rate is equal to rate constant K into the concentration of the ester into the concentration of water and multiplied by the concentration of H plus ions. The concentration of water is high and practically remains constant during the reaction. The concentration of H plus ions which catalyze the reaction also remains constant. Thus, the rate of the reaction is determined by one concentration term only, that is dx by dt is equal to K dash into the concentration of ester, the methyl acetate. K dash is the new rate constant, which is equal to the rate constant K into the concentration of H2O and the concentration of H plus. This reaction is an example of pseudo unimolecular reaction, that is the reactions in which more than one species is involved in the rate determining step, but the order of the reaction is one. The first order relationship K is equal to 2.303 by T log A over A minus X will be used. Acetic acid being a product of the reaction, the progress of the reaction may be studied by titrating the known volumes of the reaction mixture with a standard alkali at suitable intervals of time from the start of the reaction. The increase in the acidity of the solution will give the amount of acetic acid form, and hence the amount of methyl acetate hydrolyzed up to time t. The concentration terms in the above first order equation can be replaced in terms of the volume of sodium hydroxide solution required to neutralize the acid. The volume of the sodium hydroxide solution used, V naught, at the start of the reaction, that is when T is equal to 0, is proportional to the initial concentration of hydrochloric acid. As the reaction progresses, the acetic acid is being produced. The volume of sodium hydroxide solution used at time t, Vt, is proportional to the concentration of HCl that was initially present and the concentration of acetic acid, that is X. The volume of sodium hydroxide solution used when the reaction is over is proportional to the concentration of HCl and the total concentration of acetic acid. When the reaction is over, the whole of methyl acetate is converted into acetic acid, and therefore the concentration of acetic acid corresponds to the initial concentration A at infinite time. Therefore, we can write V naught to be proportional to the initial concentration of the acid HCl, Vt proportional to HCl plus acetic acid at time t is equal to t, which becomes proportional to V naught plus X. V infinity is proportional to HCl concentration plus concentration of acetic acid at time t is equal to infinity, which we have already stated that it is equal to A, the initial concentration of the ester. So, V infinity becomes proportional to V naught plus A. Thus, A can be written as proportional to V infinity minus V naught. X is proportional to Vt minus V naught, and A minus X becomes proportional to V infinity minus Vt. So, we can substitute the values of A and A minus X in the characteristic first order integrated rate equation, and we get the rate constant K is equal to 2.303 by t log V infinity minus V naught by V infinity minus V t. This is the equation which we need to use to calculate the values of rate constant K. Data of V infinity, V naught and V t, as determined experimentally, is substituted in this rate equation for various time intervals, t is equal to 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes and so on, and the value of rate constant K is determined. And we will see that this rate constant K values comes out to be a constant, and thus it will be a first order equation. Also, the graphical method can be used where the characteristic graphs of first order reaction log A minus X versus T are plotted. Therefore, in terms of volume plot, log V infinity minus Vt versus T will be a straight line with slope equal to minus k by 2.303 and intercept equal to log v infinity minus v naught. Also, the graph of log v infinity minus v naught by v infinity minus v t versus t will be a straight line passing through origin and slope equal to k by 2.303. So, we can both use the graphical method as well as integration method to find out the order of the reaction hydrolysis of an ester in the presence of acid. I will stop here today, and in the next session we will be discussing the procedure and the results and interpretation of this experiment. Thank you.